Another hobby of mine is learning and learning about how to learn better. So I'm always reading and trying to figure out how can I learn faster, how can I learn more efficiently. I've been doing a lot of audio books and podcasts. Podcasts are awesome in terms of finding stuff out, by the way. I think there's just so many cool podcasts out there now, so much information that goes under the radar. But I listen to them at 2, sometimes even 3 times the speed when you get your brain used to that. No one else wants to hear that shit, but if you have earphones in your own ear, it can be a way to get a lot of stuff in your brain really quickly. But what I wanted to talk about was how to learn, and the brain, from I guess what we know so far, has different modes to it. You heard like left brain and right brain before, but it's like a focused mode and a diffuse mode. So focused mode is I have to hammer the nail into the wall and I'm staring at the nail and I have the hammer in my hand and I have horse blinders on and that's just what I'm gonna do. And diffuse mode is when you think of all the different ways you could get something done and you start using your intuition and you're daydreaming almost. And when you're focused on something, you can't just switch into that mode right away. Maybe some people can, but it's very hard to do. Usually what happens is you go into that diffuse mode when you go on a walk, when you're driving, when you're exercising, doing something that takes up your attention but doesn't totally take up your attention. So that's why you hear of so many people, Einstein and Edison, you hear these stories about, and this ideas in the bathtub and walking. And the magic behind that is just that they're switching to a different mode of thinking and allowing intuition and tapping into that flow of consciousness and having things get figured out that you can't really explain sometimes because you're not actually trying to figure it out in a straightforward, rational way. You're not super focused. Because when you're really focused, that's really good for something you need done when you need to hammer something out. But sometimes to get creative about how to solve your problems, or especially pertaining to the previous podcast about how to design your life around getting through your problems, sometimes you need to get out of that focus mode and you can't hammer that kind of workout. You need to let that marinate a little bit. So adding those activities in when you feel like, oh, this is a waste, I'm not working, I need to be working. It's like, well, you actually are working when you're doing that. It's just a different kind of work. It's a creative work and it shouldn't be discounted.